now I would like to proceed further with our presentations and ask Dr. Iman Nasr from Royal Hospital in Muscat, Oman, to tell us more about physical urticaria and what it is and how it works.
Right, thank you very much. And I'm glad to be here with all of you in this first patient webinar. So my talk will be much easier thanks to Marcus and Disari with the physical urticaria, what it is and how it works. So physical urticaria, I'll touch on inducible urticaria. So as Marcus explained that in urticaria, there could be a cause for the urticaria or no cause found. And generally 20 to 30% of chronic urticaria, it's inducible. What we mean by inducible is that the wheals, these itchy wheals, the angioedema or both are brought about only on exposure to specific physical or environmental stimuli such as cold, heat, exercise, pressure, sunlight, vibration or water. So make it easier, we say inducible urticaria are physical and non-physical. What I will be talking here is the physical urticaria. So physical urticaria constitutes the largest group of the chronic inducible urticaria. They are triggered and they come up only when you are exposed to a certain stimuli. For example, probably rubbing, only when you rub your skin or just scratch it there, you would get a wheal or some itching at that place, probably pressure from a bra strap when you're carrying your handbag, for example, cold or heat or maybe exposed to sunlight. This is where your urticaria, your wheals, the swelling, the itching comes about. It can occur alone or with other forms of inducible urticaria, or maybe it occurs with the chronic spontaneous urticaria. So some patients might have chronic spontaneous urticaria, which comes for no reason usually. And on addition to that, it is provoked by physical stimuli. So non-physical urticarias, examples are sweat. So patients, when they're sweating, they might develop urticaria, contact urticaria, and water. So these are some examples of physical urticaria. You see here first is symptomatic dermographism, which is a fancy name of just an urticaria that comes when you scratch the skin or you rub it. You can see here the line. And a patient is really upset about what this condition, how distressing it is. Help me. There is solar urticaria when you're exposed to the sun, where you have areas of redness which are quite itchy, very annoying. There is cold urticaria when you're exposed to the cold. You can also develop some swelling and angioedema. Heat urticaria with the hot weather, and delayed pressure urticaria. And last would be vibratory urticaria. So how do we diagnose such urticarias? Very important is the history. You will tell us what exactly is this type of urticaria, what triggers it. And the physical examination, we rely on certain tests, which are probably not available in all centers, but most centers, especially the UK centers, will have these tests there, which we call it a diagnostic provocation test. These are examples of some fancy instruments, and I will go very briefly. So a Temp test is a device where it tests for a cold urticaria or heat urticaria, not present again in all centers. The patient puts the arm here and it tends to give temperatures from 4 up to 44. You keep it there for a few minutes, and we, after the test, we look into the redness and swelling. Which area does the patient or do you develop the swelling or the redness and itching? And it's very helpful because this can tell us which temperatures will you get symptoms. In centers that they don't have this test, we use the ice cube test. Where we put an ice cube in a plastic bag and we place it on the arm for 5 minutes, and a positive test would be swelling, raised skin, and some redness on that area. Now, for the scratching, we use a device like this, a Fric Test, where we apply some pressure. There are four pins here, different lengths, starting with a longer one that causes more deeper friction, and the number four, the least one, which is the shortest, only light pressure. And we see how many lines. If you have all four lines, that means your urticaria is quite active. The less lines, the better. We have delayed pressure tests, where we put a weight on the arm and we wait a few minutes and sometimes in hours for the delayed pressure urticaria. And then we observe the swelling and redness on the area where we have applied the weight. Solar urticaria, some UV visible light projector projects some certain wavelengths on the skin. And again, after 15 minutes, we read the test and we look at which wavelength does the patient react to or develop symptoms. So very common question patients would ask, how long will I have it for? Physical urticaria tends to take a little longer than chronic spontaneous urticaria that has no physical trigger, but it will eventually go away. And as Adil have mentioned with his fellow patients, some say, you know, mine is not yet gone, and comparing. Unfortunately, in urticaria, you do not compare symptoms. Each one is different. Triggers are different. Anxiety levels are different. And at the end, it is very important to say it will go away. Most important is avoidance of this trigger as much as possible. Antihistamines, again, for this type of urticaria, as in chronic spontaneous urticaria and acute urticarias, from one tablet, we go up to the maximum dose of four tablets with the physician's guidance. And there are, in some places, the injections, omalizumab, or even immunosuppressants, short courses of steroids, but we really don't advise it for longer. But what we would like to say is that please remember you are not alone. This is the You Care For You webinar, where we not only explain just about urticaria, we would like you to join us, follow us, and have more information, answer your questions, and even guide you to the nearest UCARE center close to you. We are here for you, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you.